Well, the beaten finalists from 2 years ago, Denmark, have got off to exactly the start they would have wanted here in this quarterfinal against Chinese Taipei, winning that mixed doubles in two straight games. Men's singles next, then men's doubles, women's singles and women's doubles, should we get that far. Next on court is a men's singles. Hsueh Hsuan of Taipei up against Jan Jorgensen of Denmark. So Hsueh Hsuan, the 27-year-old from Taipei, up against clean-shaven Jan Jorgensen today. I was admiring his facial hair the other day. I thought he looked very handsome with a beard.
Yep.
But perhaps but
he lost the match, so that's why he shaves, you see. I don't know.
Needs to be a little more streamlined or perhaps superstition?
Superstition, just okay. The change. Just the change.
Well, there he is anyway.
I've not spoken to him. But
a 25-year-old from Aalborg. What a tremendous match he had against Kenichi Togo of Japan. That was on Tuesday when Denmark were beaten 3-2 by Japan. And they lost to Togo, having won the first game. Lost the deciding game, having had three match point opportunities. Togo won 27-25 on his fourth match point in an hour and 16 minutes. And again, that was the second match of the tie, which was against Japan. It was 1-1 after the men's singles. Ideally, he would like to make it 2-0 to Denmark after the men's singles. But this man, Hsueh Hsuan from Taipei, wasn't selected against Malaysia. And Hsueh Hsuan was played against Lu Chongwei, and not surprisingly lost that encounter. But he did play against Germany, beat Dieter Donka in two straight games. So we know he's a very fine player. In the last record of the year, best he's done is a couple of second rounds in German Grand Prix and Asian Championships. In fact, third rounds, because both of those were draws in the last of 64, and he reached the last 16. Forget that world ranking of 135. He has been as high as 31. He's only got six tournaments towards his world ranking at the moment. That's why it's dropped so low. Jan Jorgensen, as I say, 25 years of age. Still at number 7 in the world ranking. Just one place below his highest ever, which was 5 weeks he spent at number 6 from March earlier this year, so he's just recently dropped down to number 7. Three times a medalist at European Championships, but never a gold medal. This is the third meeting between these two men. Last time they met, it was Jan Jorgensen, but it has to be pointed out that was 18 months ago. First round of the China Super Series event. It was two straight games. In fact, the first time that they played was also in China, and also a first round match. And again, it was two straight games, but that time in favour of the player from Taipei. So for our court officials, Nikola Benkova from the Czech Republic and Sudip Bhave from India. It was a great occasion for the court officials as well to officiate one of these major matches in the Sudirman Cup or any of the major events staged by the BWF, the Badminton World Federation. So Jorgensen, of course, has played twice so far. Won one, lost one, beat Derek Wong of Singapore. Denmark's 4-1 victory over Singapore.
Represented by Jan Jorgensen. On my left, Chinese Taipei, represented by Hsueh Hsuan. Chinese Taipei.
So Hsueh Hsuan E of Taipei getting his women's singles on the way. And I think if Taipei want to reach their first ever semi-final of the Sudirman Cup, I think this is a match that they've really got to look to be winning.
Yeah, it would be a good idea for them.
Yeah.
No doubt. The pressure's on. Men's doubles is up after this one, and obviously the Danes is having a very strong pair there. But it's an open match, this. You very rightly say ranking 135. It doesn't give a clue of how good the player he actually is from Taipei. And I also, I'm quite interested and keen to see how Yan is actually coping with the fact that he lost the match to Tago, and I think confidence wise.
Yeah, I certainly remember 2 years ago in the Sudirman Cup watching this young man from Taipei come to three games against Peter Gaeder. Absolutely tremendous match it was. So we know he's got quality. He's beaten the likes of Bunsak Ponsana and Taufik Hidayat at the Asian Championships 3 years ago when Hidayat was the number one seed. And I think personally, he's one of the most underrated players in world badminton. I think he's a tremendous talent.
He plays really well. And I remember the match in Qingdao against Peter Gade, and he really played well. And it was a close scare for Denmark to not lose that one.
I certainly talked about this man's qualities when he was playing against Japan, Ian Jorgensen, and his fitness absolutely outstanding.
Yeah, it is.
You were telling me, and he does tend to blow a little bit hot and cold. Of course, he's had some tremendous results. He's beaten the current world number one, Lin Chongwei. He's beaten the Olympic champion, Lin Dan. Four wins over former world champion, Chen Jin.
Yeah.
But confidence is a funny old thing in sport, isn't it?
It is. And it's a very fine line that Yan is walking every single time he plays. Because at the end of the day, when he's in there and he's really committed to win the match, he's so psyched up that he becomes erratic, and he has to tell himself, calm down, calm down, calm down. But if he calms down too much, he's losing that edge he's got from the beginning. So it's a very, very fine line for him to play.
Well, he may have missed, but certainly sent a message that he's going to.
Yeah, watch out.
Yeah.
Oh, beauty.
There you go. Power and angle, but look at his movement. Gets behind it.
And you've got all sorts of options when he's so quick getting behind you. That's what he did here. But interesting to see how likely he is to play a backhand. He doesn't mind to play the backhand. That's quite unusual for Asian players. But, you know, he's only using it going around the head when he really wants to go on the attack. Where otherwise he's quite happy playing that backhand, I wouldn't call it defense, but just, you know, playing a normal backhand and keep it in play.
That's a lovely matchup. Very similar in a way to former world and Olympic champion Taufik Hidayat was
exactly.
Always quite happy to turn and play that.
Just about saying it, exactly
beautiful.
Like a Taufik.
Beautiful, yeah.
Got a good touch to it. See, that's when he's going underneath it and attacks.
Oh, that's nice. A hold and flick from Jan Jorgensen. coming back level.
But if they carry on like this, it's a very fast pace they play, and they do not make a lot of mistakes. One of them is going to be tired, and it's interesting to see who. Oh, that was lucky for Yang. He opened up the court. And Hsuan Yi was there. He saw that easily, but he didn't put it away. Defense at the end. Backhand defense is really getting much better these days. Saw the other day against Tago from Japan, where Yen's backhand defense was really strong. And I recommended Tago to play more to his forehand. And unfortunately, he did so and won the match.
Oh, service fault called. Racket not facing in a downward direction, pointing in a downward direction. A lot of that the other day, didn't we, Morton?
Yes.
The body smash.
But not as the first opening smash. Can only come on the third or the second or the third. Not on the first one. That will never work.
What sort of an angle is that? That was tremendous. How did he do that?
Jan was laughing as well. What happened there? Play.
Oh, unbelievable smash again.
Hsueh
Hsuan seemed to go on a step ladder there. Get up to that. Look at this. Goodness gracious.
So steep.
265.
No expression on his face.
No.
Oh, is that? Okay, that's normal.
I would be very happy.
That's a good smash. And Yan is going in to the interval. Up by one, 11-10.
Couldn't be closer. Gonna have one point in it.
Yeah, Lars was very happy with how Yan is playing. Say, Yan, you play good, off to a good start. Try to close down the net. You can easily get whatever he's playing over you to the baseline. You will get that quite easily, but close down the net. Make sure he cannot play there.
The body smash again, once again. absolutely pinpointing that left hip.
That's a nice reply. He hit really hard. Such a hard smash.
It's going to go wide. Now, remember when Hsueh Hsuan reached the quarterfinal of the World Championships in Paris. It was an absolute sensation. In fact, he was a game up against the eventual gold medalist in that quarterfinal, Chen Jin. Played some breathtaking badminton. Stunning again there.
Yeah, let's get it. Keep it low for a little while, I think. Lifting too much will just give more opportunities. He's not only smashing hard, he's pinpointing them down the line. It's so close.
Not his fastest one yet. A couple of kilometers slower than one earlier. He's missed it on that occasion.
Oh, that's a nice lift. Good pressure on that lift. Not too high, not too low. Just the right height, just the right pace. Good lift, that one there. He's off balance and he's missing it.
Learning from his opponent, giving himself his own medicine. From the body smash, the angle first.
That's what Lars said, close that net down. That was a good easy point. But I think the quality of this match is really good. I'm very impressed. Long rallies, not too many mistakes. It's really good played winners.
Perhaps slightly hesitant as to whether he should have played that final shot, whether it would have gone wide, and that hesitation.
That's enough.
Forced him into error.
I think the game more or less is decided. I think Yan will win this first set and actually get onto the good side of the court in the second. So it will be a quite good advantage for the Dane, I think.
It's rather concerning to me that Josh Van Eet, after making that out, seemed to have lost his focus. He was looking around, watching play on the adjoining court. That's nice.
Cross. Yeah, by luck.
light on his feet. The player from Taipei, we know that this man is very light on his feet. He's a very good mover around the court, but a particular notice, both of them, how smoothly they both move.
Yeah. Yeah, Jan is a very natural athlete. I've said it before, but he's actually a very good runner. And when we joke with him, you know, we always say he's in the wrong sport.
Could be a long distance runner.
Yeah, long or middle distance. He's a very good runner.
And he finds the line again, just inside the singles sideline. Just 2 points in it.
Favorite smash.
And with it, game point opportunities. He did well to control that because the shuttle was spinning.
Yeah. And good of Jan to stay in it, and this, I think it was a good option.
Well, asks to towel down, and umpire Michaela Benkova says no. Good umpiring this stage of the game. And indeed, Jan Jorgensen takes the opening game. 21-18 confirms the umpire, and look at the reaction from Jorgensen. Absolutely delighted with that, and so he should be. A clenched fist, one game to the good. 17 minutes of excellent badminton for our opening game.
I think Jan has played some of his best badminton I've seen for a long time. Good first set.
Better than his first set against Targa?
Yes, definitely. The pace is better, doesn't make that many mistakes.
I said shaving that beard was making him more streamlined. What response from Hsueh Hsuan, the E. With Taipei, didn't manage to come back in this men's singles, one of the world number ones in the men's doubles for Denmark. Mathias Bo and Carsten Morgensen up next. The psychology of this quarterfinal tie will be very, very difficult for Taipei.
Such a good smash here. That cross-court smash must be the envy of anyone. That is so good.
Thank you. interesting earlier on in that rally, more than the fact that the Dane was in trouble, therefore lifted very high and down the centre of the court, not giving his opponent those angles to work with.
No angles to play, no angles to play. But again, I think he played with very good length. And obviously he's staying on the slow end of the court. And that means that he can really make good use of that baseline. And that's going out, but it wasn't. But chances were that the Taipei players on the fast end, that would have gone out. But that's really good proper length. And one more. Nice, good control.
Very good.
Yeah. That's off for that.
Looks up towards the lights. Quality of that cross-court smash up there with the world number one, Li Chongwei?
Yeah, I think so. Because not only is it hard, but powerful, it's actually quite well disguised.
Yeah.
There's a slight slice in it, just a slight.
Good rally, and I just thought in that rally that Hsueh Hsuan was perhaps beginning to read that body smash.
I must say he's been caught quite a number of times in it.
Hsueh Yi to towel down. Jorgensen takes the opportunity as well. Oh my goodness me! Well, actually, he's asking his coach, look, he's saying, was it in or do you think it was going wrong? Changed his mind, but he actually played a very good drop shot. Goodness me.
And managed quite easily to get back. Did you notice that?
Yeah. Two he left a little earlier, which both landed in. He's just
unsettling.
Yeah,
I agree. But Jan has that tendency. I must say, I've followed him for years and years, and I've actually coached him for almost 3 years now. And he's got that tendency to leave it and hope. And instead, you know, just play them. He's been playing really well. There's no reason for him to put himself under pressure by leaving these shots. He's got to be dead sure when he's leaving them.
Can't really tell who was between
foot,
us.
Yeah, the foot.
Yeah. There's a nice little 4-point cushion for Hsueh Hsuan. and that 5-point cushion. Oh, this is supposed to be the more difficult end.
Hmm.
Oh, that's careless.
Yeah. Nice to see that Swanee was not really happy with it. He was really he's way into his match now.
Whistle! And his movement forwards, forcing the Dane into error, and he goes to the mid-game interval. Hsueh Hsuan with a 5-point advantage.
He's quick on his legs.
Yeah. Very light as well on his feet, almost like a ballerina, in that they almost don't seem to touch the floor.
Bouncing around.
Yeah, it's beautiful.
Very quick.
And the Taipei coaches. To be honest, Gordon, we saw a little bit of this when Jorgensen was playing against Targo, didn't we? He was a game and seemed to be cruising. He was had won the first game, he was up in the second game, if I remember correctly, and then it all went. I think it was 15-12 he was up in the second.
And went
then
haywire.
Yeah. Very good.
Not only the smash, but the follow-up. Look at that follow-up. He's so determined. It's great to watch. Look at that. And forward.
That's gone. Ooh, it's well, I'm. Yeah, the Taipei player can't believe it. He was going to go and serve. I have to say, I concur with him.
Looked out.
That's how to respond when you think you've had a bad call. That's exactly what you should do. Probably win the next round. Channel your anger and aggression in the right direction.
A long uphill battle for Yen to come back into this set. So he's got to score points like that.
Quick points, you mean?
Yeah, not points he's got to work too much for. It's a long way up. 4 points. Close to the net there. That little extra step he took towards the net was actually what damaged him. Nice to see this one. He is picking up the shuffle to continue the game.
Suddenly a much softer smash, just going for angle and placement. Good variation.
And also in total balance.
Yeah. Oh, he's got a little bit of a cold. Oh, amazing. It's steepness of shot, and he's so crisp with hitting it down.
Magnificent shots. Yan cannot afford to play this defensive. He must try to gain some kind of upper hand and control initiative like that.
And it's just wrong. Well, it looks very much as if we'll be treated to a third and deciding game. Don't want to jump ahead of ourselves, but quite frankly, oof, well.
Yeah, it looked in to me too.
Yeah. He's not happy with himself.
No, no. He played it well. He really played it well. It was a good chance to play that cross court of the net. He got it exactly where he wanted it back, but he missed it.
First real sign of emotion we've had from first one. Guessed right, but still couldn't get anywhere near it. Yeah, your point about taking that extra little step at the net.
Yes, he comes in with such pace and power, he can't really stop. He's so quick, and that's the whole thing. And it's actually damaging him sometimes that he's so quick.
Interesting. Points, and all of a sudden the gap seems closable.
Oh, good defense in the first place, building up for this lift. Unfortunately for Jan, a miss.
That could be costly. Clearly in. Play Chua. That's a poor miss from Jorgensen, and it brings up game point opportunities for Taipei to level this one single, isn't it? One game apiece.
Two very good attacking players, and for each of them it's the world to get that initiative, to use that smash.
Oh, that is brilliant once again.
I'm sitting here shaking my head after all these fantastic smashes from Hsueh Yi. It's unbelievable.
Look at the way he pronates that forearm, creating the extra power, and most importantly, for Josh and E, and his everything to play for in the third and deciding game. this man before, being very impressed with his attacking play, but I have to say today it's been absolutely astonishing, extraordinary.
And he doesn't look affected at all, physically. Not at all.
Anything you could glean from that last remark?
Not at all.
No.
Not at all.
So here we go, third and deciding game, this crucial men's singles in the quarterfinal tie between Denmark and Chinese Taipei. Defense there from Jorgensen.
Yeah, good start. Two good rallies for Yan. Another one there.
Oh, beautiful that shot.
Poor serve. Punished.
We'll have to wait because the shuttle has gone on to the adjoining court. The
oh, they could take a new one.
Yeah, the singles players are continuing their rally. That's extraordinary. To the body smash, but that one wasn't quite as hard, and asking Hsueh Hsuan E to just put some pace on his defensive shot himself.
I think Yan is attacking just to avoid the other one attacking.
Yeah. Missed it. Somehow to miss time. He didn't seem to really jump at all on that, did he?
No.
He looked very awkward with his movement.
Well, I think the motto here is attack is the best kind of self-defense. And it goes for both of the players, and I think Yan has got really well out of the blocks in this third set.
This is a very nice lead indeed, 6-point advantage.
It could be very decisive, I think.
Yeah.
There we go again, body smash. Not only is he scoring on it, but the good thing as well is that he's closing down angles. So should he come back, there are not so many angles where Swanee needs to play. Nice.
absolutely vital as far as Hsueh Hsuan is concerned, that he closes this gap a little more before the change of ends.
Yeah, you have your wildlife on court again.
Positive, Jan Jorgensen, 8-point advantage as the change ends in this deciding game. Looking to command the rallies, looking to hit down, as you say.
Just have a go at him, that's what Lars is saying. Keep going, keep going, keep going. For Yang to get a start, decent start to the second half of the first set here.
Oh, what a matchup. Oh, rarely in men's singles do you see a player sent completely the wrong way.
And especially not someone so quick.
Yeah, exactly. He's romping away with this now. Jan Jorgensen, 10-point advantage.
Such a good match, I think, the first two sets, and then it's a little bit disappointing, but obviously most for Chinese Taipei, that you know, he's sort of lost his game, making a lot of mistakes now.
Fears it's too little, too late. Points away in his third and deciding game. Oh, make that 2 points away. That's absolutely delightful. And his spirit has been broken of Hsueh Hsuan Yi. Well, just to prove me wrong.
The place with such little effort. It's unbelievable. Nice. I wish I could have done that.
Yeah. It's landed in. Match points have arrived. Gone long. The victory to Jan Jorgensen. 21-7, the deciding game. And just 10 minutes for that last game. Danish team and supporters on their feet.
Well, 21-7, it really doesn't ring nicely in my ears.
No.
It was such a good match. The first two sets, thrilling.
Yeah, certainly was, and all credit to both players because that was an intriguing men's singles. But as you can see, 21-18, 14-21, 21-7 in 47 minutes, and it means that Denmark have a 2-love lead in this quarter-final tie against Chinese Taipei.